Hello and welcome. This is the Treasure Chest for Your Soul, and it's Tuesday, and I'm so glad to be with you. So today we want to talk about a fun thing that happens to all of us at one time or another. We go to sleep in different states. We might have just done a gratitude journal. We may have felt really good about the day. We may feel like we're on track or not. And we wake up in the morning with the blahs. Yep, it happens, the blahs. Or we wake up cranky. Or maybe we're deeply sad. But let's talk about the blahs, because that sort of incorporates a number of things. So imagine if you wake up with the blahs, and there you are, what do you do? What do you do? How do you get your soul fire ignited? How do you get yourself engaged in life again? What is this wet blanket that's come over during the night that you're not so thrilled about, but there you are in the midst of it? Maybe it's lightweight, but maybe it's a down comforter that's 4 feet deep. And you're like, oh my gosh, how am I going to make it through this day? I don't like my job, or whatever it is that you have in front of you, it doesn't get you inspired. So, now we've been taught to meditate. We've been taught to go into a peaceful place, find our center. That can be great. But sometimes we need a little soul creative kick in the pants to move out of this feeling of blah, wet blanket, lack of motivation, what the heck am I doing here? I've got no direction and purpose, etc. Then we go into the story about, you know, who we are and who we aren't and all of that. What about if you're sitting in the blahs and you go, this is that old pattern trying to keep me in survival, trying to keep me in that place of being dull and not getting very far. I think I'd like to be a grand creator. Now, that may feel like a huge leap from the flat line to grand creator. But all you have to do is spend a few minutes moving some creative energy. How do you do that? Maybe you keep a coloring book by your bed. Maybe you keep your phone, your iPad, or something by you where you can play a piece of music that inspires you. Maybe you can even, while you're still laying down, do a little body motion and get that sensual creative energy going in the lower half of your body to start to just turn that pattern around, that you are in life and life inspires you because you are creating from life energy. And then your soul goes, yes, I'm right there with you, and let's move forward in inspiration. But igniting that flame takes a moment of you moving out of the doldrums of just surviving and the collective depression. I don't want us to have any excuses that there's a collective depression and therefore we're caught in it. But there is some weightiness around sometimes that we have to work a little harder to create through, to love through, to ignite fire through. So these are certain ways you can do that. Maybe it's dreaming up what you want to make for dinner, or doing something a little more adventurous than you might do in your heart, in your brain. Think of possibilities. So rather than looking at the day ahead as a flatliner of possibilities, start to feel into what it would be like to be a creator and get some of that creative juice going. All I have to do is look at the flowers next to me and I'm like, woohoo, let's do this. Let's be a flower and burst forward in what we have to bring today. But it takes bringing it into my body for sure. So I support you in any way that you find that will allow you to ignite in the moment that you wake up, in the moment that you're feeling a little cranky, in the moment that you're going, oh my God, is this all there is today? Is this it? I'm excited for you and your new possibilities for sure. So creation, creating, you are a grand creator, and your soul and all your guidance and the whole universe supports you in being that. All you have to do is flip that switch and you got it all pouring in right there for you. Try it. It's worth it, definitely. So glad to be with you in this creative time, for it always is, regardless of what's going on in our outer world. And just a reminder, we have a Clear Your Path to Your Soul's Prosperity happening May 1st to the 7th. I'm so excited about that opportunity to not only clear out the doldrums and get your soul moving into its prosperous self, but lots of creativity that you've never gotten from me before that just keeps coming down the pike. And if you want to know Curious Georges, yes, there will be a 14-day immersion in June. So save some creative juice for that, because we're going to skyrocket into life with that one. So many love, blessings of joy to you. Don't you love that phrase? Love, blessings of joy to you? I think that's a keeper in this day. And be sure and share with your friends these creative tools that come forth for us, so that you can have that community with you of those who get you and understand you and are right there with you in creating all the time. Much love to you.